Yes,
hello.
sir.
We will start now.
Yes, yes.
Meanwhile, others will keep on joining. Anyway, the things are on recording.
Yes.
If someone joins late, they can refer the recording. I hope the recording is also available to those who are absent in this class. We have not joined so far. All right?
Yes, sir.
Genetic algorithm is the pioneer sort of algorithm in the field of metaheuristics, right? There is a lot to learn and copy the design from nature. Many things are inspired from nature. Many things in nature give the clues of optimization. Many algorithms are inspired from nature. We already have seen one such algorithm, that is Anscombe optimization. Another algorithm which we have seen is particle swarm optimization. Simulated annealing is a little bit inspired from technology, but more from nature. The crystallization behavior as the temperature drops down is not human created behavior, right? That is the behavior which is understood by human, that is actually natural behavior. So many algorithms have been inspired from nature. One such algorithm which has become very popular, that is genetic algorithm. It takes clue from nature's evolution process. We know the Darwin's theory of evolution, and we very well know the statement that survival of fittest, and every next generation is better than previous one. This is the only clue which will be taking ahead in this genetic optimization by genetic algorithm. Though mathematicians create the basics of GA has become very popular due to its capability of giving optimal solution to practical problems, accommodating practical considerations. Amongst many non-traditional algorithms, GA has become most popular. GA is most robust amongst all non-traditional algorithm. So there are various names to the algorithms. The algorithms which we have seen so far, these are called as non-traditional algorithms. These are also called as metaheuristics. These are called as algorithms inspired from nature, etc. Right? Why this is a problem? Next. So we have already discussed these things earlier when we were discussing our Anscombe optimization. The algorithms which we have learned in nonlinear optimization techniques were valid for unimodal functions. Like this which you are seeing is unimodal. It has unimodal means which has one peak or one pit. This is also unimodal because it has only one minimum point, one pit. Right, but as far as this function is concerned, this has multiple modes. This also has multiple modes. And we are interested, as far as optimization is concerned, we are interested in reaching to this point, or we are interested if our objective is to maximize, as far as this function is concerned, we are interested in reaching to this point, right? But the algorithms which we have learned in nonlinear optimization techniques like dichotomous method, Fibonacci method, univariate, Powell's pattern search, and so many, will get caught in certain local optima. For example, the process may lead us to get this point as optima, but we know very well that this is the optima which we are interested in, right? So these methods which we have learned are not capable of letting us reach to the global optima. They are fine for a unimodal function because while we optimize there, as there is only one optima, and the chance is that we will be reaching to that definitely. But here, we may not reach. Most of the time, we do not reach to the global optima. We get caught into local optima by the method which we have learned, right? Right? So this genetic algorithm was originated by Professor John Holland, the student of Michigan University, MIT, in 1975. And further, it was taken up by David Goldberg, student of Professor Holland, right? John Holland. Kalyanmay Dev also contributed. Kalyanmay Dev, the professor from IIT Kanpur, has contributed and is contributing development of genetic algorithm. GAs are robust. Robust means they are applicable to any kind of problem. Okay, genetic algorithm can be applied to any optimization problem. To which we find another techniques are difficult to apply. You can apply GA by a little bit of tailoring to apply GA to the problem. Like generations can survive under hostile condition. Those are called as robust generation. GA also survives or can be applied to various problems, various difficult or simple problems, right? In the language of optimization, robustness means how many different classes of problems it can solve, right? Some of the things we will be skipping for making this lecture start, right? Are you listening? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Getting the things so far?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Voice is clear? Voice is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. So this is this is another multimodal function, right? So this will be first of all taken care of by genetic algorithm, but soon we converge to the range wherein we are very sure that there is only one mode. Then the things are taken up by what is called as the algorithm from non-linear optimization techniques, the algorithms like dichotomous search method or Fibonacci search or golden mean and so on. Okay. First of all, we try to converge the region wherein we feel that global optima lies. From this point to this point, by genetic algorithm, we come to this range, and then we take up further proceeding by the known algorithm. It's not mandatory to do so. Okay, we can continue the things by using genetic algorithm to its entirety, right? As we have seen earlier, that the functions of when the function is multimodal, this is a multimodal function, Rosenbrook's function, this is called as, okay? We will be solving, we'll be getting the optima for this Rosenbrook's function by using genetic algorithm. We have already seen this function in particle swarm intelligence, and probably we have seen the optimization of this function by what is called as simulated annealing. Okay, our idea is not to get the best solution. In genetic algorithm or any algorithm which we have seen recently under the heading of meta-heuristic, we are not interested in getting the best solution. We are interested in getting better than existing solutions, right? Then directly coming to this flow chart of genetic algorithm. Okay, we first encode the population, right? The purpose of encoding is that we should be able to carry out genetic process on the population. Okay, right? If we have simply the number, then we have not so far used the numbers for carrying out genetic process on them directly. So what we do, we first encode the population. How it is to be encoded, that we will be seeing soon. But you just understand, we take it to certain another presentation. Okay, not directly. We do not perform the operation directly on the numbers, right, to begin with. In our primitive algorithms, we will be encoding the population, right? Then what we do, the idea of all these algorithms is to get the solution from the solutions. Okay, so we will be first having the population of solution. Okay, population of the solution will be encoding. But before encoding, what we do, we find the fitness function. That is, we find with that solution, what is the value of objective function. Okay, in genetic algorithm, objective function is called a fitness function. Okay, this goes in line with the theory of genetics or theory of evolution by Darwin, wherein he talks often about survival of fittest. And hence, in the genetic algorithm, in place of calling something as objective function, we call it as fitness function. Objective function and fitness function are the same thing. Right? So, from the population of solution, for every solution, we find the fitness function, that is value of objective function. Then we rank the population according to the fitness function value, right? We get the ranked population. Then this ranked population will undergo the genetic process. Okay, genetic process dominantly consist of crossover operation, right? Crossover operation, you will be soon seeing. You will be soon seeing what is encoding, what is crossover operation. Crossover operations in the cross, just to give you an ready idea, use the idea of crossover. There will be two chromosomes which will be undergoing certain genetic process. Okay, what these chromosomes are, that will be clear to you after a while. So when these two chromosomes undergo genetic process, some part of one chromosome will swap with another chromosome. Okay, say there is chromosome A and some chromosome B. So some part of chromosome B will attach to chromosome A, and that some corresponding part of chromosome A will attach to chromosome B, right? So new chromosome will form as a result of crossover operation. Then mutation is another operation in the genetic process. What is the purpose of mutation? After the crossover is done, then some of the gene in the chromosome will change its value. Okay, that process is called as mutation. Okay, we'll be seeing how that mutation goes on. This as these terms are taken from genetics, you will find it a little distant from you, being the students of optimization. But soon you will know that these are much easier things, right? So after crossover, new chromosome is formed. On that chromosome, mutation is performed. Crossover is almost an essential operation in a genetic process. Mutation is not that, it's essential operation, okay? Mutation, we may do in 5% of the cases, 10% of the cases. This we will be setting right in the beginning of algorithm, okay? If we set mutation probability to 5%, we will ensure that mutation doesn't occur in more than 5% cases. Crossover will be, however, taking in 100% of the cases. Okay? Now, because of these two operations, we will be getting new chromosomes. Okay? And we will be having new population. As we have our parents have generated our population, we will be generating new population, and we are finding that every new population is better. The reason of that population being to be better is not just because we are generating the new population or we have been generated by, we have been produced by our parents. Environment is also contributing certain role, or the competition in the generation is making the next generation better than previous one. Okay, there are something in every generation. There is a thirst for quest for finding newer and newer things is making the generation better. But that is not modeled in this genetic algorithm. Okay, all in all, the crossover process and mutation. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Crossover and mutation process will be generating new population. And that new population, again, fitness function for that new population will be found out, and that will be again sorted, or that will be, that new population will again be ranked on the basis of fitness, right? The ranked population again will be undergoing certain that kind of genetic process, which include crossover and new chromosomes are generated. Then on some new chromosomes, mutation will be performed and will be getting new population. And a new population, again, the fitness will be found. That population will be ranked, and again, the crossover genetic process will be performed, right? So you once again see this algorithm. The population is encoded, then the fitness is found on the basis of fitness. The population is ranked. The ranked population, from the ranked population, selection is done. Mating pairs are formed. On that mating pairs, crossover is performed. New chromosomes are obtained. Mutation is performed. Then some of the chromosomes from this new chromosome population will get modified, and then the new generation will be created, and it again the cycle will repeat. Now we will be seeing various things in this flowchart in little detail, and after all those things are seen, we'll be solving one problem. Okay, I want you to make this thing very natural. Okay, you should not be required to learn this algorithm from book or any other video, right? So we'll be seeing what is encoding, how the fitness function is found out, then how the selection is done, how is the crossover done, how is the mutation done, etc. Right? This flowchart is clear to all of you? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, encoding, just once again, this flowchart, okay? Encoding the population means we create chromosome-like structure, okay? Chromosome-like structure means, suppose say, it is some numbers. So for example, we have some problem, like say, Rosenbrook's function. And we have got value of x1 as 3.2 and x2 as minus 4.3, for example. Okay. Now to perform genetic process on such numbers, we have not thought of so far. Okay. Because they don't genetic, for performing genetic process, there is a need of chromosome. And these numbers do not look like chromosome. So what was done in the primitive attempts of genetic algorithm, that these numbers were converted to binary form, right? You are seeing, and this binary form has the look of chromosome, okay? It has the length and it has the values. It has some components called as genes, right? 1 and 0 sort of things, right? This is not the only way of encoding the population of solution. Okay, this is one of the way, and this is this was the initial way of encoding the population. Okay, right? That is the way of representing the solution in a binary form. That was considered to be encoding in earlier days, right? There are another ways of encoding. Before I come back again to this flow chart, we will be seeing various ways of encoding. Like for example, let x1 be 15, x2 be 4, x3 be 21, and x4 be 7. There is one... there is a problem wherein we are interested in finding the values of x1, x2, x3, x4, for example. Okay, so instead of going through certain process to find the value of x1, x2, x3, x4, we directly take some random values of x1, x2, x3, x4 within certain range, like we had been having the range for x1, x2 in the problems we solved by simulated annealing, particles or intelligence optimization. So here also there would be range on the values of x1, x2, right? So x1 is 15 and it is very much in the range which is specified. X2 is 4. I'm just giving you an example to demonstrate encoding, right? X2 is 4, X3 is 21, and X4 is 7. Now, they don't have the chromosome type of look. So what is done, 15 is converted into binary number, right? You see here, for converting 15 to binary number, right, how many... bits will be required? How many bits will be required to convert 15 to binary number? Actually, 4 bits will be required to convert 15 to binary number. Actually, 4. Because when we set all the 4 bits equal to 1, then it makes 15. But in this problem, we are seeing that there is one number 21. Probably with those 4 bits, 21 won't get represented. That's why we plan that we will be having 5 bits and 5-bit structure, 5-bit encoding. will be representing the numbers up till 32, right? So we first decision is to decide how many bits will be required. So by seeing all the numbers available to us, right now only one record is available. By seeing all the records available to us, we'll be coming to know what is the last number we have to represent. And for example, it is 21. Then for representing 21, it is very sure that we will be needing bits not less than 5. Okay? Because 4 bits will be representing number up till 15 and 5 bits will be representing number up till 31. All right? So 21 is in between 15 and 31. That's why 5 bits will be required. Okay? And this is the chromosome for representing this solution. 0111100100, like that. This is the chromosome, right? For example, now there is little bit of problem in converting some numbers to binary. For example, 4.87, right? 4.87, you know that this is a floating point number, that is double number. You don't know the data type double in computer languages. Now, converting 4.87 to binary form is not easy process. Okay, it is difficult to convert 4.87 to binary. Okay, because means you have to do the treatment different on the left-hand side number and to the right-hand side number. So all in all, it is difficult, right? But converting integer numbers to binary is easy. So what we do, instead of sticking to 4.87, we multiply 4.87 by 100, make that number 487, and this 487, we convert to binary, okay? Right? So we do not stick to floating or double decimal numbers when we want to solve the problem by genetic algorithm, right? We rather prefer to convert them to integer. So suppose say it is asked to you in problem that the precision I want for up till 2 decimal, then you need to multiply the numbers by 100, right? This thing once again will be referring back when we actually come to solve, when we actually will be solving the problem. But you understand the thing in bits, right? So this is one kind of encoding, right? So if we are sure that the that a variable x lies between 1 to 5 and we need 2-digit accuracy, mean 2 decimal point accuracy, 9 bytes will be required. Why? Because your number, maximum number to which you have to address is 500, because your number will be 5.00, because you want the accuracy till 2 decimal. And we have resolved that we will not be converting the decimal numbers to binary. So what we prefer, we will be converting decimals by multiplying here in this case, thereby make 5.00 to 500 means nearest binary equivalent is 512. Okay, 500 means we will have to take the number up to 512, limiting binary number to 500 to represent 500 is 512. 512 requires 9 bits to represent. Okay. So our chromosome for X1 will be 9-bit long. Okay. One other thing you should remember is you can have different chromosome length for different variables. Like for X1, you may have 4 chromosome length if you are sure that the number will not exceed 15. For X2, if you are sure that the number will not exceed 9, a number will not exceed 8, then you can have the chromosome length for X2 equal to 3 and so on and so forth, right? If the accuracy goes on increasing, the length of chromosome also increases. So that was a binary encoding, right? There are another forms of encoding. This is also the encoding. The number in its original form can also be taken as, means without encoding it, we can proceed ahead in genetic algorithm. Okay. Whatever the number in the population is, in our primitive algorithms, we used to encode it as a binary. But nowadays, people have tried the genetic algorithm without doing any kind of encoding, means keeping the numbers as numbers. Sometimes the encoding is alphabetical, like A is treated, 1 is treated as A, 2 is treated as B, 3 is treated as C, and so on. Okay. Sometimes the encoding is in terms of colors, right? Okay. Here is one example, interesting example, is tree encoding. Tree encoding means this is standing for, this structure which you are seeing here is standing for an equation. What is that equation? X plus 5 divided by Y. This is standing for X plus 5 divided by Y. Many times you must have came across a puzzle wherein some numbers are given to you and the operator in between this number is missing. And the result is given to you. That is, for example, 5 blank 3 blank 7 is equal to 2, for example. Now you have to find out the operators in between. For solving this problem, the tree encoding is used. This tree encoding encodes the equation like X plus 5 divided by Y. Okay. Like the operator is placed at the join and the variables or the values are the three nodes. That is tree encoding. Right. So we have learned about encoding. Right. We will come back to algorithm. We will be having the population of the solution. And that population, we will be encoding. Most general encoding or very common, often used encoding is binary conversion. Okay. Sometimes color encoding, sometimes keeping the numbers as they are in the solution, means doing, not doing any encoding. Okay. Or replacing the numbers by alphabets. These are all the ways of encoding. Right? Understood? Hello?
Yes.
Hello? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Huh. Siddesh? Siddesh is there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Vikram?
Yes, sir.
Kushbu? Kushbu is there? Okay. Anyway, so far the things are okay. Some theory I have to explain you to make you convergent with the terminology in genetic algorithm, right? Fitness is a measurement of the strength of solution, right? Now we'll be coming to, once we find the solution, once we find various population of solution for every population, we find the every member in the population, we find the we find the objective function value, or we find the strength of the solution. That is called as fitness. Now, once we get the fitness, we rank the solution. We rank the solution, and after ranking the solution, there are ways of selecting the population for generating new population, right? So we will be now coming to selection. Okay, there is one thing called as roulette wheel selection. There are various approaches of selecting the population for generating new population, right? You know that many of the boys in your generation do not marry. So everyone doesn't contribute to the generation, to generate new population. Okay, many do not marry. Many do not marry because of their weaknesses. Many do not marry because they lack the fitness. They are not selected for contributing to the generation of new population, right? So here comes the role of survival of fittest. So there is a roulette wheel selection. Okay, what is done based upon the strength of the solution? A pie chart is prepared. You might have seen this pie chart so often. Okay, a pie chart is prepared. Now, what is done with this pie chart? The some solution, suppose say it is having very less fitness, and some solution will be having high fitness. High fitness will be getting, will be represented by high value of pie, high slice in the pie chart. Okay, and less fit solution will be represented by small segments or small sector in the pie chart. Okay, now what we do once we draw the pie chart for the fitness function, okay, fitness values, we will be firing the random number. And suppose say our pie chart starts will be fired, starts from this at zero. We'll be firing a random number, and if that random number falls in this pie, okay, this solution is selected for generating, for being the member of generating the new population of solution. Okay, this sector being of bigger arc length, okay, there is high probability of many random number falling in this sector, okay, and this sector being smaller in size, our random number, there is less probability of our random number falling in this zone. Okay, so we will go on firing the random number, and we will go on seeing in which pie slice they fall. Okay, and in whichever pie slice they fall, that solution is pushed in the lot which will be helping in generation of new population. You take this process as very simple. Okay, so among the class, suppose say I have to do the selection for a certain purpose. So I'll be finding the solution who have better potential for performing the task. Okay, I will be coming, I'll be selecting some good students, some Professor Madarkar will be coming, he will be selecting good student for his society, and someone else will be coming, and he will be selecting good. So those students who are fit, those students who have better fitness value are more likely to get selected. And those students who have less fitness value are less likely to get selected. At times, they may not get selected. Okay, so this is roulette wheel selection. Roulette wheel means I have simulated, just emulated it by taking a random number. Roulette wheel, you know that the wheel will be rolling, and it will stop suddenly. Wherever it stops, that is selected. Okay, that is the winner. That is selected. Steady state selection will be just skipping for now. Elitism is another strategy. Op selection. Elitism means that the best solution in the present generation, multiple copies of that best solution are made, and weakest solution is removed from the present. For example, you have the population of 10 solutions. Among these 10 solutions, some solution will be giving you the least weakest value of the fitness function. And some solution will be giving you the best value of the objective function. Now, what is done? The solution with weakest value is removed from the chunk of the 10 solution, population of the 10 solution. And the strongest value, strongest solution, the solution giving the best fitness function value will be copied, multi-copied. Okay, so because I want 10 population of 10 solution. Now that I have removed weakest solution, one weakest solution, what I'll be doing? I'll be making two copies of the strongest solution, making my sum equal to 10. Sum of the population of solutions equal to 10, right? Suppose I remove two solutions, right? So what I'll be doing? How many copies of the strongest solution I will have to make so that my total population of solution is equal to 10? Go remove here, so I'll be taking two copies. Okay, if I remove one solution, I'll be taking one copy of the strongest solution. If I remove lower two, I'll be taking two copies of the strongest solution, right? Or might be one copy of the strongest and one copy of the next strongest. Okay, I have the freedom. In genetic algorithm also, I have the freedom. Means freedom to the extent that by keeping these terms, I can devise my own genetic algorithm. Many people have devised their own genetic algorithm, their own strategies of selection. Okay, these are commonly used strategies. One is what I spoke about, that was roulette wheel. Another is elitism. Elitism means the best solution is multi-copied. Best solution or solutions are multi-copied, and weakest solutions are removed so that you are left with better population of solution. Okay, this will undergo the genetic process. Okay, if the better population is involved in genetic process, the generation which will be getting will be better. That's an idea, right? Now we have seen so far in encoding means converting your solution to a form on which genetic algorithm can be performed. Then we have seen selection process. In selection, you have roulette wheel selection. This selection is based on the fitness function value. We prepare a pie chart. Okay. Another strategy is elitism. Okay. There is one more strategy, that is tournament selection. Okay. Tournament selection, I'll be coming across. This is tournament selection. Okay. Tournament selection, what we do? we take out two chromosomes randomly, okay, from the population of 10 chromosomes, I will be randomly taking out two chromosomes, like here I have taken. There is a population of 10 chromosomes, out of which I have taken out two chromosomes. Now, out of these two chromosomes, one chromosome will be having higher fitness value and another will be having lower fitness value. By comparison, I'll be getting this is, for example, he is having better fitness value and this is having lesser fitness value, right? So the green one, I'm calling as, because it has higher fitness value, better fitness value, I'll be calling it as winner. And another, I'll be calling it as loser. So what I'll be doing, winner I will be directly transferring as it is to the new generation. Winner I'll be transferring, like you just show here, you just follow the cursor. This is a winner, this is a winner, this is a winner, this is a winner, transferred to new generation, new population. Whereas loser will undergo a genetic process with a winner. Okay, the crossover process will be performed with the winner. Some component of the winner will be swapped, will be means the this portion of the loser will be removed from the chromosome and this portion will be placed here. Okay, and then if required, mutation process will be performed on it and this gene will get transferred to the new population. Okay, right. Another two chromosomes from the present population will again be selected parallelly and will be compared for better fitness value. Okay, better fitness value chromosome will be considered as winner. Lesser function value will be loser, and there will be again random placement of some component of the winner to a loser, and if required, mutation will be performed, and that new pair will be the member of new population. Okay, once we get the new population, means 10 pairs again, 10 pairs here. Okay, the same loop will be performed. This is called as tournament selection, right? This thing you have to understand now, because we will be implementing this story soon, right? Understood so far?
Yes, sir.
Vikram?
Yes, sir.
Siddharth is there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And now we will understand the crossover. Right? Now just consider that there are two chromosomes. Okay, right here. This is a parent one and this is another parent two chromosome. Right? What is done here? Some random number is taken. Now in this chromosome, you just see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 genes are there. Okay. Same numbers of genes are required to be in right. Now we will be firing a random number. Okay, this is random number best procedure, right? We'll be firing a random number in between 1 to 16 and say that random number falls 5. Okay, so we will be placing this red mark right as shown here in the parent 1 chromosome and parent 2 chromosome. Okay, the red mark will be at the same place in both the chromosome. Now what is done? This part of the chromosome is placed here and this part of the chromosome is placed here. Okay, so we get the offspring 1 and offspring 2. Okay, simple, right? Now another, this is single crossover site crossover. Okay, this is double crossover side crossover. Just look at here, right? I have taken two random numbers now, okay, and arranged them in the sequence. For example, first random number was 5 and another random number was something like 12. Okay, another random number was 12. So first crossover mark I have placed here and second crossover mark I have placed after 12. And same I did in the chromosome of parent 2. Now what I am supposed to do, this middle portion I'll be swapping with this middle portion of the parent 2. Parents 1's middle portion of the chromosome of parent 1 is swapped with the middle portion of the chromosome of parent 2. Here you see how those are swapped. Okay. So I get new chromosomes. All right. There is another approach of crossover. What is done in this approach? Just you go on firing a random number at every gene. For example, here. Okay, if the random number comes less than 0.5, then we do the crossover. Crossover means that gene will be flipped. Flipped means not flipped actually, that gene will be swapped. Okay, in between parent 1 and parent 2. And if the random number comes greater than 0.5, that gene is not swapped. Now here, both the genes are same, so there is no, means if your random number comes less than 0.5 or greater than 0.5, doesn't make a difference. Okay, here both the genes are same, here both the genes are same, so it doesn't make a difference. Here both are same, here both are same. So till fifth position, both the genes are same. Now, in sixth position, I'll be firing a random number. And if that random number comes less than 0.5, I'll be taking this one above and this zero below. Right? You got it? Okay. So one has taken above and zero has come down. Likewise, here also that has been done. Here also that has been done. Probably at those three places, your random number would have been less than 0.5. But if it is greater than 0.5, you keep the genes in their original positions, right? So you more than these things, you are just understanding so that if you have your own idea of doing the crossover, you can always implement that idea. It is not that you have to stick only to these three types of crossover. You can have your own idea of crossover, right? Now, this is the style of crossover. If your chromosomes are binary strings, but suppose say your chromosomes are indicated directly by number. For example, parent 1 number is indicated by 0.3, encoded to 0.3, or directly it is 0.3. Okay. And parent 2 chromosome is 0.5. Means we have not done any binary encoding for the parent, for the solution. Probably we have kept the solution as those are, or after encoding, this comes like this. Okay, solution appears like this. So to get the value of the offspring, what is done? One random number we fire. Okay, so we fire a random number A into parent 1. Okay, A is a random number basically. And 1 minus A into parent 2. Means suppose say I have taken a random number, for example, 0.7. So I'll be multiplying 0.3 with 0.7 and 1 minus 0.7 by 0.5. So thereby, this will come 0.21 and this will come 0.15, getting me the sum equal to 0.36. And this offspring is found by just doing the thing reverse. This is multiplied by 0.7 and this is multiplied by 0.3. So 0.3 into 0.3 means 0.09 plus 0.35. Am I right? 0.35 plus 0.09 gives you 0.402. Likewise, all these chromosomes are the in every case, this has been demonstrated by taking a random number 0.7, but random number won't be 0.7 in every case. Just for demonstration purpose, we have taken it 0.7. Every time, you will have to fire a new random number. Whenever you need a random number, you will be firing it new, right? This kind of encoding is done when you are dealing with number. You may have your own idea of crossover. Crossover, the simple purpose of crossover is to generate new population by doing certain process on two solutions. Okay, on two parents. Here you see, I have one parent here. This is indicating an equation x divided by y plus 3. Another equation I am having y square minus x. Now I have to do the crossover. So what is done here? Here is a crossover site. Here is a crossover site. This portion you are seeing y plus 3 portion is attached here and this portion is attached here, getting you two offspring. So new equation then becomes x divided by y square. Okay. So depending upon problem, you can have your own strategies of crossover. Okay. And one more strategy of crossover I need to explain you. Right. This one. This crossover we have seen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So what is done here? We mark a crossover site here, then this portion goes above and this portion comes below. Okay, but here we are from this is a chromosome in some application. This is the crossover in some application. Now, for example, I am having an application in traveling salesman problem. My chromosome is indicating the sequence of the locations the traveling salesman will be visiting. For example, I am having one sequence that the traveling salesman is visiting is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right? And another sequence, another chromosome, for simplicity, another chromosome I am having is 9, 3, 7, 8, 2, 6, 5, 1, 4. Now, the requirement of this chromosome is that every number should come once and once only. No number should be repeated. Now, when we do the crossover, there can be a problem which has occurred here. In the parents, you were finding that the numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No number has repeated. Here also, no number has repeated. But when we do the crossover, the numbers are repeating. You see? 4 and 4 is repeating. Okay. 5 and 5 is repeating. That we do not want. When we do the crossover on the chromosomes in the traveling salesman problem. So what is done? Just look at here. This poop, I have taken a crossover, two random numbers to mark the crossover site. Okay. Here and here. One random number comes equal to 3 and another random number comes equal to 7. So I have marked crossover site after third position and another crossover site after 7th position. And same marking I have done in another chromosome here. Right? Now, this PS marked in gray, I am bringing here, okay, like 4, 5, 6, 7, I have brought it here. 4, 5, 6, 7, I have brought it here. Now, these places I have to fill. These places I have to fill. The blank places I have to fill. But while filling, I have to be careful that no number is repeated. Okay. Now, I know that I already have 4, 5, 6, 7. So, I should not have in the empty places no number out of 4, 5, 6, and 7. So, remaining number I have to keep. So, the number which I have next in the another chromosome, that is 1. Can I place here 1? Yes, I can, because 1 has not appeared so far. Okay, so it will not repeat. So I'll be placing 1 here like I had done here. Then the next number comes 4. Now can I place 4 here? Is a question. 4 I cannot place here because 4 is already there. 4 is already there, so I cannot place 4 here. So I will move my pointer from this 4 to this 9. Can I place 9 here? This is the empty location. Can I place 9 here? Yes, I can, because that number has not appeared so far. So the next number which will be written in the new chromosome will be 9. Right? Now, our pointer will come to next empty place, that is this one. And on this side, my pointer will move to this 3. But a question once again I'll be asking, whether I can place 3 here. Yes, I can, because 3 has not appeared so far. Okay, so after successful placement of 3 here, my pointer will move to the next empty location and pointer will move here also. Now that is telling me to assess the possibility of placing 7 here. Can I? No, I cannot, because 7 is already there. So 7 will not be placed there. So the pointer will simply move inside this area. 8. Can I place 8 here? Yes, I can place 8 here. Can I? Nine was placed here, then was the turn of 3, then was the turn of 7. No, this is the place we are yet to fill, because 7 was not filled there, because 7 was already existing, so 7 was not filled. We come to the next number here, 8. The question we have is, can we fill in 8 here? Yes, we can, because 8 has not appeared so far. So we fill this location with 8, and we move the pointer to the next empty location. And next empty location, the question is, can we fill in the next number from the parent? Okay, 2. Okay, the 2 has not appeared so far, so we can fill in 2 here. So all the locations have been filled, all the empty locations have been filled. So we have got the one offspring from here. Likewise, we can get offspring from this chromosome also. Where what I have to do, 8, 2, 6, 5, I'll be placing here, and then I'll be questioning whether in the empty location can I place 8. No, because 8 has already appeared, so 8 will not be placed, so pointer will move to 9. 9 has not been placed, so 9 will be there. Then the question will be asked about 1, and 1 will be placed in the next location, and so on. I hope you have understood what precisely you have to do. Okay, so that is how new chromosomes will generate, right? So this I will not take for you, because this is again a process, but little bit complex one. In the presence of this crossover process for traveling salesman problem, we avoid to use this one. this I'll not be telling you, but sometimes if you suppose say get interested in understanding, you can understand the thing just by referring, pausing this video here, and but just by following the direction of the arrows, you can understand what is done, right? Now we'll come across, we'll come on the mutation process. Mutation process means mutation. Have I explained it in binary cases? No, I have not explained it in binary cases, but because just see here. Now, mutation means once you get the offsprings after crossover process, you do certain changes in the chromosome obtained after crossover process. You fire one random number, you fire another random number, and then what you do, you swap their positions. One way of mutating is you place 5 here, you place 2 here. Or what you may do is you will be getting you will be having 5 here, and then you will be pushing rest of the number later. That is also possible. There is no crystal, there is no the only way of doing mutation. You can have your own way of mutation, but whatever you decide has to be your way of mutation has to be followed throughout, right? This is swap mutation, this is insert mutation. Names do not make much of a difference. If you understand, if you want that the mutation is to be done this way, you may give it a name or you may forget its name. Right. Just for namesake, that is insert mutation for permutation, and another is swap mutation. Sometimes the block mutation is also performed. Like for example, you have a chromosome 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You select 2 random numbers, and you revert the string in between, like 5, 4, 3, 2, like done here, or scramble mutation. Okay, like for example, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and in this you scramble these numbers in between. Purpose of mutation is just increasing the variety in the offspring. Okay. Because if you continuously go on performing the crossover operation only, after some time you will find that same offspring are getting repeated. The percentage of a new offspring getting repeated will increase. By doing mutation process, that probability of repeating the chromosomes will reduce. Okay? Right? Okay. Mutation here, like here, for example, we in the case of binary string, suppose say we get a random number. We get a random number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 we have got. And first of all, whether or not we need to do the mutation, that has to be cleared first. So we first of all decide that the mutation probability is 0.5, or we have to do mutation in 5% of the cases. So we do, we fire a random number, and if that number comes less than 0.05, then only we fire another random number. Okay, and that random number, if that random number comes less than another random number comes equal to 4, then we will be going on to position 4, and if there's 1, you will be That is mutation in binary chromosome case. Okay. In this case, suppose say I get a signal for a mutation. How do we get the signal for mutation? I'll be firing a random number. If that random number falls below 0.05, that is the indication that I have to do the mutation. If the random number obtained is falling beyond 0.05, if it is coming beyond 0.05, oh, that is the indication you don't have to do mutation. So if you get the signal that you have to do the mutation, you will be firing another random number between 1 to 16. And say that random number comes equal to 7. So you will be going to 7th position, and if the number there is 0, you will be making it 1. Okay. This is what is the mutation is. Right? This thing we have already seen. Right. How to do the mutation in case of the numbers, when your population, just your population is not encoded, or after encoding, it looks like this. Okay. So for mutating, what is done, we add certain random numbers. Okay, we will be first selecting, whether we have to do the mutation or not. If number comes less than, random number comes less than 0.05, we'll be going ahead. Otherwise, we'll be stopping. Then we'll be firing another random number. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, five numbers are there in a chromosome. So what we'll be doing, we'll be firing a random number in between 1 to 5, and suppose say that comes 3. We'll be adding certain adding or subtracting another random number from it. Okay, like for example, 0.11 was the next random number, 0.13 was the next random number, minus 0.13. So we subtracted and got this number. And if we want to do mutation here with the due signals, like whether to do the mutation, at which place to do the mutation, and what will be the addition. Again, all this will be coming by a random number. Or you can have your own strategy of mutating these numbers. You may come across altogether new problem. There you may have your own encoding. There you will be requiring to have your selection process. You will be required to have your own crossword, your own mutation process. Okay. It will be your own algorithm, and this is the reason why genetic algorithms are becoming popular. Okay, the users think that I have a lot to contribute to it. Okay, and that's why it's not the case that you have to follow or you are the slave of the algorithm. You have to follow the instruction the algorithm gives to you. Here, algorithm has given you a skeleton. It is not more than the skeleton. Okay, many things you have got the liberty to decide. And because of that liberty, many people got attracted to this algorithm. Okay, this was the creation of computers, science, professional software engineers, okay, who didn't like mathematics. Okay, but they knew that by doing some jugglery on the numbers, they can reach to the optimal solution. Okay, the another advantage of this genetic algorithm, like think that parallel processing is possible. Like you can have one chromosome on one machine, another chromosome on another machine, and you can employ third machine for carrying out crossover and mutation operation. and fourth machine to collect the offsprings. Okay, you can plan the parallel processing of the operation. And nowadays, many computers resources are underutilized. Okay, so by offloading some processing of someone's genetic algorithm on someone's empty resource of the computer, the optimization can take place very easily. You don't need to have the computer with high specifications, right? So this is the genetic algorithm. Finally, you have to stick to this. You have to stick to this flow chart. Okay. As you go through the problem, you will understand what to do the next. Okay. In the next about something like 15-20 minutes, I'll be explaining the implementation of genetic algorithm. So far, I have not taken your feedback. I'm not able to see all of you here. Siddesh, Vikram, process is understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Siddesh?
Yes, sir.
Somebody's voice I'm not listening. Probably he is not using mic. Yeah, you. Understood or not? Hello?
Yes, sir, understood.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Understood, no? If you still have some doubts, no? You can just once again go through this recording and you will understand. I'm sure you will understand everything. Okay? Let me get the feedback. Ankit is there?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Mohit? Mohit is not there. Okay. Two girls are there. One is Khushbu and another is... what's her name? Bhumi. Bhumi is there? Hello? No.
Okay. No, sir.
Okay. So I'll stop the recording here, and once again, because otherwise this recording will go unmanageable, then once again I'll be starting the recording for the problem. And through the problem, everything will be clear to you, I'm sure. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Let me stop the recording.